Hey, I'm Evan, head of engineering for RM Stator. Let's upgrade the regulator on your Polaris RZR. Okay, so we're going to start with removing our regulator. This is a 2012 RZR 900 XP four-seater. On the 1000s and the two-seaters and the other models, they all have the regulator mounted in this general location. Sometimes it's kind of on the back of firewall here, sometimes it's underneath. But they're all in the same location. They mount with 10 millimeter hardware, 10 mil bolts and nuts, so they're easy to get off. So I already have everything loosened here. Now, if you're installing our relocation kit, I suggest that you remove the bracket that the regulator is mounted on, since it's a nice piece to reuse to remount your regulator up front. If you're installing a regulator in the stock location, then you just go ahead and remove the two bolts that actually hold the regulator to the bracket. So I already have everything loose. I'm gonna go ahead and get the regulator removed. Okay, so now we install our new regulator. You just mount it in the same location. It lines up with the bracket. Reuse the original 10 millimeter hardware and snug everything up to the bracket, and you're ready to go ahead and plug everything in. Okay, so we need to get access to the wiring harness for the regulator so we can unplug it. On this four-seater model, we have two rear seats to remove, and we have an access hatch here. On the two-seaters, there's just an access panel in the back here that has to come out. So I've already removed one seat. I'm going to remove the other one on this side. Okay, and then on this four-seater, the access panel has two little clips here that you have to turn to unlock. There's one on each side. I've already done those. So I'm gonna lift it up, pull it back, and get it out of the way. And then looking down, you can see inside the connectors for the regulator are accessible. Okay, so we have access to our connectors now. We're gonna unplug our old regulator. So the stator connector on all regulators looks like this guy, and just unplugs, disconnects. Now, depending on which style you have on this 2012 XP900, we have this regulator where the battery connections are ring terminals, as you can see here. The black wire, the ground side, mounts to this bolt right here that's grounded to the chassis, and it's a 10 millimeter. And the red wire, the battery positive side, mounts to the starter solenoid right here, which has a 10 millimeter nut. So I've already disconnected both of those, and I'm going to remove them. So if you have the other style regulator, which is used on the newer models, the XP1000, it'll have connectors just like this. The stator connector is the same. 3-pin connector that just unplugs. The difference is the battery side is a red and black wire in a 2-pin connector like this. So it'll be mounted in this same location, and you disconnect it just like the stator connector and unplug it. Okay, so we're gonna plug in our new regulator. Stator connector is the 3-pin plug and plugs in just like the original. Just push them together and they will lock. Now, the battery side connector for this XP900 is the ring terminals. So they're gonna mount in the same location. The black wire grounds to this mounting bolt here down at the chassis. And the red wire attaches to the starter solenoid terminal here. Both have 10 millimeter hardware. So that's it for installing that type of regulator. If you're installing the other type that has a 2-pin plug for the battery connection, the stator side's the exact same, plugs right in. And instead of having to mess with ring terminals, you can just plug in your battery side connector to the mating connector that is in this location. So anytime we're doing any work on the charging system, it's a great idea to go ahead and check it when you're done and make sure everything's charging well. So here I have a voltmeter hooked up to our battery. It's set to the 20 volt DC range. So we're measuring the resting battery voltage right now. And with our new regulator installed, we're gonna fire up the motor and rev it up a little bit and make sure it's charging. This battery's not fully charged, so I expect we'll see somewhere around 14.4 or so volts. The regulation point on these regulators is about 14.6. So with a fully charged battery, you should easily be hitting that. I think we'll be just under that. So I'm gonna go ahead and fire it up and watch the meter. Okay, so there's our idle voltage, which is good. We're over 14 volts at idle. that's great. We're hitting 14.4, almost 14.5 volts, which says we have a strong charging system and our regulator is working correctly. So that's about it. You definitely want to check this out every time you do any work on the system just to make sure everything's working well. And that'll ensure that you have a reliable charging system.